chambers. It's a standing room only audience. They won't let people in, and if you leave the room to go to the restroom or get a drink of water, you can't come back. That's how full it is. It's a very busy day, and it looks like a long agenda, and we're all here fighting for a great city. And I'm standing here next to Dick Platkin, who's got some suggestions for increasing revenue, which is one way of addressing a budget crisis, is to look for good sources of good money rather than looking for more pockets and more things to cut. So what are your comments?
Okay, well, my comment is that going back to the Bradley administration, the mayor's office, one after the other, and the city council have given enormous gifts to large real estate projects like Hollywood and Highland, LA Live, the Staples Center, the Grand Avenue project. And it's taken the form of waiving millions and millions of dollars in fees, outright loans, and then the construction of necessary infrastructure. And I think the time has come to expand the discussion to identify all of these sources of lost revenue for the city, as well as the contracts, the development agreements that could be now abrogated to get an infusion of this money instead of having the city give gifts, reclaim them. And the test would be if they provided jobs. The rationale was, give us money to Hollywood and Highland and we'll provide, we'll have jobs. I don't think there's any evidence the jobs have appeared. They haven't fulfilled their part of the bargain, and those gifts need to be returned to the city. So that would be my proposal. And I think it's time for neighborhood councils to identify all of these lost revenue and add that to every debate about the budget from this point onward.
Excellent.
Okay.
Good to see you here.
By the Mothers of East Los Angeles. Last year, because our grant was cut to $7,000, it used to be as high as $25,000 on a line